Hello students, welcome back. In the previous videos, we have discussed about the history and introduction of trigonometry. In this video, we will discuss the topic in detail. The first and important component which we should all know about to deal with trigonometry is angle. So what is an angle? Angle is a measure of rotation of a given ray about its initial point. Did not understand? Okay, look at this. This is a ray and this is a fixed point. I'm moving this ray with respect to the fixed point, which is called as vertex. If you see, the measure of rotation is called an angle. And original ray is the initial side and final position of the ray is called the terminal side of the angle. We can also observe that we can move the ray in clockwise direction as well as anti-clockwise direction. If the direction of rotation is anti-clockwise, the angle is said to be positive, and if the direction of rotation is clockwise, then the angle is said to be negative. The measure of angle is the amount of rotation performed to get the terminal side from the initial side. And as we can see, angle can be measured, which means it should have some units. Yes, there are several units for measuring angles. The first is the degree measure. If the rotation from the initial side to the terminal side is 1 by 360th of the revolution, the angle is said to have a measure of 1 degree. Further, 1 degree is divided into 60 minutes and a minute is divided into 60 seconds. Here are some angles whose measures are 360 degrees, 180 degrees, 270 degrees, minus 30 degrees, 420 degrees and minus 420 degrees. The second is the radian measure. This measure involves circles. Angles subtended at the circle by an arc of length 1 unit in a unit circle is said to have a measure of 1 radian. Now that we are saying it is a unit circle, the circumference of the circle is 2 pi, correct? Thus, 1 revolution of the initial side subtends an angle of 2 pi radians. These are the units in which we measure the angles. So the next topic is about how radian and real numbers are related. So what is the relation between radian and real numbers? So let us consider this unit circle with center O. Let A be a point on the circle. Join OA. Consider OA as initial side of an angle. Then the length of an arc of the circle will give the radian measure of the angle which the arc will subtend at the center of the circle. Consider the line PAQ which is tangent to the circle at A. Let the point A represent real number 0. AP represents positive real number and AQ represents negative real numbers. If we rope the line AP in anti-clockwise direction along the circle and AQ in the clockwise direction, then every real number correspondent to the radian measure and conversely. Thus, radian measures and real numbers can be considered one and the same. Similarly, we will find out the relation between degree and radian. We know a circle subtends an angle whose radian measure is 2 pi and its degree measure is 360, which means 2 pi radians is equal to 360 degrees, or we can say that pi radians is equal to 180 degrees. So this is the relation between degree and radian, and this enables us to express a radian measure in terms of a degree measure and also vice versa. Also sir, why write it pi when we can have the approximate value? Sure, let us substitute the approximate value of pi, which is 22/7. So now, we already know that pi radians is equal to 180 degrees, which means 1 radian is equal to 180 degrees by pi, which is equal to 180 degrees by 22/7. Solving that, we get an approximate value of 1 radian, which is 57 degrees and 16 minutes. Therefore, 1 radian is approximately equal to 57 degrees 16 minutes. And 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radians, which is approximately equal to 0.01746 radians. This is all about the relation between radians and degrees. And with this, we can convert any given radians to degrees or any degrees to radians. Some of the standard degree to radian conversions are 30 degrees is equal to pi by 6, 45 degrees is equal to pi by 4, 60 degrees is equal to pi by 3, 90 degrees is equal to pi by 2, 180 degrees is equal to pi radians. So students, this is all for today's video. Hope you all enjoyed the class. See you soon. Till then, stay healthy, stay safe, ciao.